观众朋友您好，欢迎收看全球趋势新闻，帮你挖掘好新闻，我是 Bonnie。 英国首相强生和未婚妻席孟兹29号在伦敦的西敏寺大教堂秘密结婚，根据了解，婚礼的宾客是直到最后一刻才受邀，甚至连强生身边的员工事前都毫不知情，可以说是保密到家。从英国首相官邸公布出来的照片中，可以看到两人在花园相视而笑，神情相当轻松。
The couple hosting a small group of family and friends who were reportedly only told themselves at the last minute. Even the Prime Minister's sister, Rachel Johnson, earlier refusing to reveal whether she herself had attended.
现年56岁的强生和33岁的席孟兹在去年二月宣布订婚，并且宣布席孟兹已经怀孕。去年的4月29号，两人生下第一个孩子，这是席孟兹的第一个孩子，而强生则是第六度当爸爸。
COVID rules only allowed 30 people to attend, but there are questions over whether Catholic rules allow the twice divorced Prime Minister to even marry here. Divorced people cannot remarry in Catholic ceremonies, and although Boris Johnson's previous two marriages were outside the Catholic Church, some priests are still not happy.
First and second marriage would not be counted as marriages at all, and therefore he would be free to marry. Now, the problem is in the perception. People are understandably concerned that the Catholic Church looks as though it's making an exception for somebody who is powerful and privileged, and that would not be available to ordinary churchgoers.
上一次在任内结婚的英国首相是1822年的利物浦，距离现在已经相隔了199年之久。据说强生曾经要求亲朋好友把2022年7月30号这一天空出来，因此让外界揣测婚礼将在那一天举行，没想到强生只是故弄玄虚。
They walked into Downing Street after the election win.
巴西足球巨星内马尔在2020年与 Nike 结束了长达15年的合作关系，当时就引起外界震惊。最近的《华尔街日报》独家爆料，原来内马尔疑似是因为试图性侵一名 Nike 的女员工，并且事后拒绝接受调查，才逼得 Nike 提前和他解约。这消息一出，立刻引发各界讨论，而内马尔涉嫌性侵的新闻已经不是第一次。
曾经是 Nike 的最佳代言人，有穿都穿不完的球鞋，还有幸跟篮球之神迈克乔丹一起出联名鞋。
Diferente, me sinto feliz de um sonho conquistado por poder ter um tênis meu agora. Eu quando me falaram da ideia, ainda mais com Jordan, eu fiquei extremamente alucinado.
出身贫寒，却靠着足球自己也变成大明星。现年29岁的内马尔13岁就跟 Nike 签约，去年无预警结束了双方长达15年的合作，如今被爆出内幕。
The Wall Street Journal reports Nike cut ties with soccer superstar Neymar last year after he refused to cooperate with an investigation into a sexual assault allegation made against him. In 2016, a Nike employee told friends and colleagues that Neymar tried to force her to perform oral sex in a hotel room in New York City. 2 years later, the Nike employee filed a complaint with the company. Nike says it was, quote, deeply disturbed by the claims, but that an investigation was inconclusive.
对于指控，内马尔强烈否认，表示跟 Nike 解约是基于商业考量。他也发文说没机会向被冒犯的人解释，甚至根本不认识这个人，没办法了解他痛苦的真正原因。大家批评他没被保护，但身为运动员，他觉得自己也很赤裸，认为 Nike 背叛了他。不过这其实不是内马尔第一次传出性侵争议。
Ele te obrigou a manter relação sexual?
A partir do momento que ele me segurou violentamente me batendo, ele estava me obrigando a ficar ali naquele lugar.
Sem uso de preservativo?
Sem uso de preservativo.
Foi assim que aconteceu a relação sexual?
Foi assim que aconteceu.
2019年6月，一名巴西女模也曾公开指控内马尔对她性侵。
Porque o que aconteceu em um dia foi uma relação entre homem e mulher, dentro de quatro paredes, algo que acontece com todo casal. E no dia seguinte...não aconteceu nada demais, a gente continuou trocando mensagem.
内马尔强调两人两情相悦，他爸爸更出面指控女模是仙人跳，自导自演，事后性侵告诉被取消。而这一次又爆出内马尔性侵，拒绝调查，才让 Nike 斩断合作关系。 不过尴尬的是，内马尔效力的球队都还是穿 Nike 设计的球衣。尽管双方翻脸，看来内马尔还是免不了上场身披 Nike 战衣。
在巴西的里约热内卢，许多因为疫情而失业的民众只能居住在巴西国家石油公司炼油厂的区域内。民众苦不堪言，哭诉他们被留在这一片荒凉的灌木丛中，自生自灭。
Você mora de aluguel, você tem que pagar uma luz. Se você mora emprestado, você tem que pagar, ajudar em alguma coisa de alguma forma. E não estava tendo condição para o alimento direito, entendeu? E aí.Foi essa dificuldade toda que fez a gente vir para cá.
截至目前为止，巴西已经超过1650万人感染新冠肺炎，超过46万人死亡。虽然巴西政府在2020年补助了将近6800万名民众，不过还是无法避免许多企业和商店倒闭，或者是营业时间减少。而这3000多名流离失所的民众用木头制作帐篷和临时建筑物，表示他们会住在这里，直到政府为他们提供代替的住房为止。由于香港的新冠疫情越来越稳定，而且疫苗逐渐普及，民众渐渐开始能够享受户外的活动。一间户外餐酒馆就提供了各式各样好玩的游戏，带您来看。
Yeah, well, I think events are never easy in general. They're especially more complicated during a pandemic. We're very fortunate to have all the experience from our last event, the grounds, and apply that to the lawn club. And we have the support of the various different government departments to try and create a safe space and safe environment for guests to be in here. So we have to think through the whole event experience from start to finish and make sure it's a safe space for guests.
在这间餐酒馆有经典的草坪游戏，像是滚球、地直球、锤球和玉米洞等等的游戏。在过去的2周中，香港每一天的病例数都在单位数，因此政府也放宽了社交隔离措施，其中也包括了重新开放游泳池还有海滩。历史上的今天要带您回到1740年的6月2号，今天是施虐狂一词的起源，色情文学作家萨德侯爵的生日。他出生在法国巴黎。萨德侯爵出生在法国最古老的贵族家庭之一，一生经历过法国大革命和拿破仑崛起，这些都是法国历史中最波折的时段。不过萨德的一生几乎都在精神病院和监狱中度过，主要有两个原因，因为他置身无数起性虐待丑闻，还有他奇特的文学创作。萨德最开始的作品都是游记，不过从1782年开始，他的作品内容和风格开始变调，经常讽刺神职与上层阶级的人，还有露骨的色情文学。其中《索多玛120天》就是他的经典作品之一。因为萨德对性虐待的喜爱，20世纪后的精神学家以他发明出“施虐狂”一词。1814年，他在精神病院中离世，而他的生平故事以及作品长期被埋没。一直到19世纪中后期才逐渐现身。But the Marquis was a noble, so of course his in-laws. 感谢您今天的加入，以上是我为您整理出来的国际新闻。喜欢我们的朋友，记得要订阅我们，同时要开启订阅小铃铛，让我们继续帮你。